Good morning, everyone. It's me, Jeff Ignacio, the owner of this channel, Sukati Pelanggan. Thank you so much for subscribing. For those who have yet to subscribe, what are you guys waiting for? Good morning, good morning, good morning. Today is 28th of May, three more days, then we're entering June. Okay, at this hour, I woke up and suddenly thinking about her. I do not know why, but I was browsing through YouTube this morning while I'm still lying on my bed, and yeah, I want to react to her interview. Okay, she is known, like a lot of people know that she can't speak English lah, she can what lah, she can whatever. But actually, she produced one album, and she sang quite a number of English songs. Like she covers a lot of English songs. Okay, and for me, she is excellent. I understand hell well, even though yes, of course, as an Asian, you cannot be like native speaker, even though some can. It's because they really put emphasis in how they want to sound on studio, or you know, or probably they are like, for example, they are probably Korean American, or any other things, or maybe they are Japanese American, so they sound like native because they probably stay there. But some actually don't sound like native, even though they have been there for like 10-15 years. It's very personal. For me, it's unique in a way. You get to, you know, do you call it slang or accent? I always have problem with these two things. But yeah, you don't have to sound like speaker. You don't have to sound like the native speaker just to speak English. Come on, it's you. Moreover, this lady, you know, a lot of people bash her because she can't lash, she what, whatever. But on certain occasion, I heard her speak. She speaks good. Seriously. For me, it's enough as long as people understand you, you know. After all, English is not our first language, especially for her. Her first language has been Malay, and she has produced a lot of Malay album, and only one time she produced English album, which is very good, but I do not know why. It cannot like grow. But somebody told me that her PA said that probably it's not the market, so she can produce singles as time goes by. Alright, so without further ado, I am going to react to Siti Nohariza interview with Fly FM. As we all know, Fly FM is an English channel. Alright, so I do not know how, but I still gonna react in 3, 2, go. Love this song, it's very powerful song, you know.
Wow, I like that. Cool.
Look at her, she is so pretty. But I do not know why, but I can sense that, like,
hey, I like it.
She's a bit shy, worried.
Oh my gosh, I like it.
She is so gorgeous, you know, with all the rantai around her neck.
So we're all very excited. Dato' Siti Nohariza is sitting next to me for the first time in my life.
Right now. Oh, she's so pretty!
About some gadget he got for free.
Do you want to go to Korea?
Small room or?
Yeah, small room like that.
Okay, so anyway, she's getting prepared to go on air.
Got
live for the first
time. You listen to her, you know, when the camera was not focused to her, this is the thing. When the camera was not focused to her, she like talk like normal things. Like she sounds so good, seriously. Let me repeat that part.
Gadget he got for free.
Do you want to go to Korea?
Small room.
Yeah,
small
room like that. Okay.
You see? She looks so confident with all the hand gestures.
One, the only Dato' Siti Nohariza.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh my gosh.
Hi.
Every time I see her, I get excited.
I don't know what to say.
Okay, saying the same thing.
Thank you so much. I'm so nervous.
Are you really nervous?
I mean, from the voice, yes, but...
Thank you for having me here.
We're so excited, before we get started, of course, we want to ask you about your new collaboration, which we are pretty excited about as well.
Yeah, she's a bit shy and worried, nervous.
Before we get into the collaboration, right?
Because this is something...
I want to talk about your beautiful skin.
Okay.
Everyone's saying that you got really beautiful skin.
Thank you. Thank you. Due to simplicity.
She's just direct. No bunga bunga. Just say it out. Okay, cool. Short and simple. Because I know probably it's hard for her to, especially when she's nervous.
Myself, husband and partner in this business.
Ah.
She's very otai.
Very otai.
I'm so lucky.
Guys, I do not care. Even though this Fly FM is an English station, but yeah, being city and whoever else, if you can't fluently speak English, like how some people can speak it, go belasa with your first language. Yes, you can speak a bit of English, more English and a bit of Malay, or it doesn't matter. People still gonna understand you. Why? Because the person who is listening to this channel is Malaysian, and if you have problem with Bahasa Malaysia, then seriously, it's a serious problem.
To have all of them.
Are you looking for new partners, fat, fame, and
men? Yeah, but can you work for men or not?
We are looking for men's product. So maybe you guys can be.
Oh, you see, very smooth the way she construct her sentences.
See, now it's become better. Perfume coming up soon.
Yeah, in April.
Right.
Yeah.
You must be really busy. Your new album.
You're a very busy lady. That's why I wonder how she managed her time. Seriously.
It's okay.
Got time to rest and relax.
Used to it.
Used to it, yeah, wow. 20 years.
Okay, we have Datuk Siti in the house, we're gonna move on to...
She's such a sweetheart.
Yeah.
I'm sure you got lots of problems when you go out.
Is that her handbag? I don't think that's guy's handbag, right?
What's the worst thing that has happened to you?
Oh.
Has a fan done anything to you? The worst thing?
Maybe I would say, my cycle.
Psycho fan.
Oh, scary.
The other
psycho fan. I don't know. I like the way she sounds in English, you know.
He always follow me.
Uh-huh.
Every
and she tried her best.
One time I went to Langkawi for
good past tense.
Right. Mm.
And then I saw
him.
Just, yeah.
What was he doing?
If only this is Malay, it's very easy for her. Like,
almost looking lip up by the beach, there pretending to be a tourist. Oh no! Oh,
but he wasn't doing anything like buka baju all that. Don't have.
No.
So sekarang he's disappeared lah.
Disappeared, and I don't know where.
You don't need to know. You see, she keeps on looking. I don't know what's the paper down there. Maybe it's her information and whatnot. I feel is it right word to say kasihan? No, it's just too much. The word is too much. It's like she keep on looking down, like bowing down. I suddenly feel emotional because I feel like it's such a struggle for her to be like the center of the highlight and to speak the language that she don't really comfortable with. But I admire her perseverance to just keep on, you know. I will say it later on towards the end of the video.
Okay.
Okay.
So my fan semua dah
terlalu excited.
See how smooth she speaks bahasa, I mean, to explain things. All she need to do now is actually to be to keep on talking, you know, English.
Dulu ada wig yang macam letak saja kan.
It's like a clip like that lah.
Clip, yeah. So dia dah tarik, so I ambil kat tangan dia
pula. That's funny.
With Sean Kingston. Oh my gosh.
Pretty
exciting. Yeah, a second single called Remember You from your latest album called All Your Love.
Her
right?
Body language shows
so tell
a bit
us about
of like
your second single.
Second single,
this is our queen guy.
My latest album All Your Love. My first collaboration with an artist from West.
I know, right? Exciting.
The song actually about remembering that special someone from past.
Oh really?
Fat
Fabes.
Friends.
Hey, you know we met, right? Long time ago. But you
you
heard the story right now.
And then, so meaningful.
It's an info. I believe, before anything, they will, give you. Do they give you the question way earlier?
We
or?
To record in the same studio. I did in KL and Sean in US.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah.
To to give the best for this song.
Yeah, it sounds so good. I love that song.
Wow.
Remember oh, you, look at her close like up, man. The skin.
To all of my fans.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
Man.
Yeah, of course.
She said it. Oh my gosh, let's play it then. This
I can't
is coming
imagine
from,
if she speaks English like.
For all your love.
I
it's
don't
remember
know.
You, Sean Kingston, Cynthia,
and she looks so beautiful. Seriously, she's so pretty.
Oh,
thank you. Oh my goodness, so much love.
Oh my goodness.
It's just, I'm speechless. Now this album is really out there. You can pick it up. It's called All Your Love.
Yes.
Yeah. The single.
And she has that light makeup on her. I kind of like her light makeup than those thick heavy ones. Maybe the thick heavy ones is
because I still
performance, right?
Looking for the best script. Best story.
Right. Uh-huh. Okay, what would you be a villain? like an evil auntie or something.
Oh no, evil auntie. No. I want to be a fighter.
Wow, you want a fight type movie?
Action movie.
I got a script.
Oh yeah.
She's a huge fan of Kill Bill.
These two people are very fun. Wow.
So you watch 1, 2 and all that. Kill Bill. Okay.
Kill Bill.
You like
Kill
Bill?
Yeah.
Are you very good with knives?
Yeah, you wanna try?
Okay. Oh, with you anytime.
So, okay, so the type of movie you're looking for is
she's so funny!
Right, you heard that, huh? So,
she collaborates.
She keep on like,
with local artists. Bring
to that to her lips.
Or foreign or local, doesn't matter.
She looks so cute!
Collaborate with next.
So sorry.
Okay, I would love
she's married.
To work with Yuna.
Yuna, oh, right?
Mm.
Well, I saw you with Yuna on TV.
Yeah, that was for
a
RAI program last year.
Yeah, Yuna and Siti Nohaliza actually sound
how
good together, to be honest.
Yeah!
Oh, I have
you sure?
Direct to
yeah!
Yuna, right?
We can sing very well.
Uh-huh.
Catfish will give you a personal
thing
later
on.
Yeah, okay, thank you so much, Dr.
Okay.
Siti. So it's on, huh?
Okay.
We will work on it, huh?
Yes.
So we'll write something and we'll give it to you and we'll sing together.
Okay.
And from the manager,
deal.
It'll happen.
Okay.
Oh,
okay.
Okay.
Sounds
like a plan.
Dato Siti in the house. And where can we find you, Dato Siti, online?
Okay. My fans, you can follow me on Twitter.
Yes.
C at C.
Okay. The alphabet C.
Yeah. N. Alphabet N.
N. Okay. C D N.
Alphabet N.
Nurhaliza 11.
So C at
CT
Nohaliza 11.
Okay. Oh, thank you, Dato Siti.
Thank you very much.
Woo. Fly fam.
Where can we put us? Yes. Okay. Nice.
You know, I've seen CT Nohaliza's signature, and I admire it really much because her signature is beautiful. And can you imagine doing this?
Okay. Thank you
to
so
all
much.
Posters or to all. Okay, done.
Let me just continue. Can you imagine doing that signature of Siti Nohaliza for fans? Like, you know, wanna ask for signature and whatnot. Can you imagine doing that for 50 times? What more 1,000, 10,000, how many hundred thousands or millions of signature has she released and that kind of signature? If I were a celebrity or artist and people probably want my signature, I would try my best to do a short one. Like create a short one, you know. But from her signature itself, it shows how sincere, how honest she is in doing her thing. Can you imagine typing pula, writing Siti Nurhaliza on all like paper lah, or probably cap or her album cover and whatnot? Can you imagine how she do that? And every time she has like this fan meet and whatnot, it's not like few hundred, it's like can reach probably 1,000. And for her to do that same signature every time is crazy. That's our queen, Dato Sri Siti Nohaliza. Alright, I wasn't expecting anything because I'm more into like, you know, like worried for her because, yeah, a lot of people say things about her English. But she did well. She did fantastic. Like I said, she actually can converse. When the camera wasn't really focusing on her, it was just like a glimpse when the camera moved, she speak like, you know, normal, you know. Probably in front of the camera, it added pressure to her. And like she said earlier on, she feel very nervous. And when you are nervous, whatever you want to say in here, we like fly, and then you'll take time to like, you know, to gel it well again so that you can converse well. All right, Siti Nohaliza. And then I can relate it to myself, all right? As I've mentioned to all of you, I am a Malaysian-born Filipino, meaning to say my parents are Filipino. We're supposed to speak in Tagalog and Filipino. They call it not Tagalog anymore, it's Filipino language, and one of the dialect called Bisaya. Here's the thing. Whenever I go back to the Philippines, I will speak English most of the time. A bit of Tagalog, which is like 1%, and a bit of Bisaya. I'm more fluent in Bisaya. The problem is here. It's very hard for me to construct the sentences. I have to think first in order for me to talk to my cousins and to my auntie or to my niece or to my nephew. It's very hard. So, because I just don't want to waste time of like trying, okay, how to say this, how to mix, how to make one sentence to this, the only way is English, because English is already like programmed in my head, and Bahasa Malaysia is of course my first language, but since in Johor I speak more English, so it can somehow English a bit more, and Bahasa turun sikit, but I can speak Bahasa very well. Okay, now back to the English. A lot of you feel like shy, and then or maybe some of you like look down on people when your friends started to speak English. Alah, poyo lah you, cakap lah BM, orang Malaysia juga, or whatever lah. As you know, we learn English since if you're from kindergarten, then it's from kindergarten. If you're from primary one like me, then we are from primary one until probably you go form 6. That is how many years, 11, 12 years of your life learning English, alright? But of course, in school, we only have that one time per week or two times per week English. So, and then we are surrounded with people who speak bahasa kebangsaan. So it doesn't really help unless if you put effort of listening, or you're surrounded with the people that speaks English. You know? So, for me, in order to improve this problem, is you have to help yourself. See. I did not master this language until I entered college. It was a tough journey for me, even though back in school I'm one of the best students when it comes to English, because everything is written and less talking. Unless teacher asks you to read something, then that's the only time that you speak. Or else, all the while we speak BM, or to be more specific, Bahasa Sabah. Uy nah, astaga siano begini batu? That's how we sound. But when it comes to English, it's only during the English class. So in order for you to improve, I can give you a few tips. Number one, listen to more English songs, or watch more English movie. Read more newspaper, especially. I don't like reading novels and whatnot, because I have books, and after 10 years, I still on the second page. Okay? Read news in English, and if you do not understand certain word, you garis lah. And please practice, keep on practicing, meaning to say practice like talking. And of course, you know how I learn? My friends will laugh at me, alah Kony, it's not like that lah, what did you say like that? I feel like alah bodohnya saya, alamak malunya saya. But that's how I improve, you know. Some people will make fun of you, but actually they want you to improve. It's just that they don't know how to teach you like teachers. So being friends, they will always like make fun of you. But please lah, jangan lah jadi hati tissue, right? So you have to really keraskan hati you that you want to learn. See? And of course, when I read comments from people who subscribe to me, maybe, or don't subscribe to me, maybe give comments, you know, just because I speak in English, then you comment in English. Sometimes I don't understand what you're trying to say. But I try to choose words, then I try to understand, okay, this is what he or she is trying to say, okay? But honestly, don't give up trying. Even though grammar tunggang langgang, this and that, go on. And when people try to fix you, when people try to teach you, be open to it and accept it, okay? Because nobody is perfect, and this is how we learn. But if people want to tegur you, want to teach you, and then you say, alah, biarlah, penting orang faham, cannot. You have to be open and learn. Okay? About Siti Nohaliza, she is amazing. She has grown leaps and bounds from the day that she became an artist. From all this, I heard, like, I believe it's rumors. Like, if it's true also, I don't mind. It's funny, like I heard the rumors, but I cannot share it. Okay? Like, you know, when she was asked something and she responded different things. Maybe probably she misheard things, alright? So we can't blame her 100%, probably she was tired. So for her to be in this channel, to be daring enough, even though she feel nervous, but she go ahead, just the spirit. And I believe she learned from there. And with Datuk K, with the son, with the whoever is surrounding her, I believe it helps her environment. See? So yeah, don't bash people just because they are not good with it. After all, Bahasa Malaysia is our first language. So if you can speak English a little, enough for you to understand, enough for you to communicate with people, that's more than enough. But if you wanna put more effort so that you can speak, okay, sebagai contohnya, like me. You know, you can speak like me, even though I am not the best example because I'm also not good in English. It's my grammar also tunggang langgang. But if you want to be like at least me, like me, speak more often and surround yourself with people who speak the language. And ignore those friends of yours or strangers who, ala poyo lah you, cakap lah BM, kan bahasa kebangsaan. Yes, of course, everyone knows bahasa kebangsaan. So what's wrong for us to learn one new language when English is not an alien language to us? We have known this language since when? Independence? Because this is our second language, you know. Seriously. So yeah, thank you so much guys for watching this reaction. I really feel excited watching Siti Nohaliza speak English and trying to form sentences. I know it wasn't easy for her, but she did it anyway, and that is something that we should applaud and not bash. Alright, like I said, always, we are not perfect, but we can always be kind. So guys, thank you so much for watching this reaction. If you think I deserve your subscription, click subscribe down below and hit the notification bell. Comment down below whoever what you want me to react. I apologize that this video is kind of long. Okay, so thank you very much. Bye-bye.